Bye-bye. To the east, she said. So this way. Right. Edgewater. Oh, there it is. I like this weapon. This weapon's cool. Sword I'm not majorly keen on. Let's have a look what's up here. Nothing really, just... Oh, it's just another pathway. Oh, okay, so it's... There's no beaten path that I have to follow. That's cool. I like this. Pretty as well.
Whoa, hey. Where'd you come from? Don't go ambling out in those hills. That's Marauder territory, friend. You talk too pretty for a Marauder. Most of them just grunt and yell. Ain't safe out here. You'd best head into town. Avail yourself of Edgewater's high walls. And low, low prices. Pleased to make your acquaintanceship. I'd shake your hand, but I've been hauling corpses. You don't want none of that on you. Name's Silas. Junior in humor for the town of Edgewater. We're all part of the Spacer's Choice family. Definitely not the junior in humor, that's for sure. If you've got business inquiries, you should stop by Reed Thompson's office. He's up in the tower above the cannery. Head into town, follow the road. Look, you obviously ain't a worker. What's your racket? You a smuggler? Freelancer? Edgewater is a company town, board owned and operated. That includes the cemetery. None of us own our grave sites. We rent them from the company. Renting means money. Money means paperwork. Paperwork means signatures. Some of our families become a mite delinquent in paying their dues, you see?
You want me to collect what's owed to you? I can do that. You're making people pay for their own graves. Why can't you collect these fees yourself? Why can't you collect these fees yourself?
Got a backlog of graves to fill. Bodies won't bury themselves, you know.
All right, I'll collect your fees for you.
Four workers still haven't paid up. Phyllis, Conrad, Ludwig, and Martin Abernathy. He's a special case. You may want to twist his arm a little.
So, I've basically...
He just is. Look... I don't want to get into it. Just make sure he pays up.
So, not even in the game 5 minutes, and already...
Conrad's got a barbershop in town. Phyllis works at the cannery most hours. Abernathy... I ain't seen him in a few days. His domicile is near the cannery. You'll find him in town. All except Ludwig, that is. He's over by the landing pad. Yeah? You could look at it that way, I suppose. You could look at us and say, those Edgewater saps lost near every soul to plague. But you'd be wrong. We're survivors. Loyal company folk, brave in the wilds.
You're not worried about falling sick?
Every now and again, a virulent plague sweeps through our town. That's life on the frontier, I suppose. A body grows accustomed.
I should go.
Working at the channel.
Let's have a little look. And oh, what we got? I got any mag picks. Shit, I should have. Can I have a shower? I can't have a shower. Can I use? I need to poop. Hey, magpick. Basically everything that's not nailed down. Any magpicks up in the top? Edgewater Cemetery discovered. What have we got here? Messages. Your subscription to you. Edgewater Cemetery is property of the Spaces Company. It takes care of its own. I'm not going to steal all of the spades. You want your own. Of course. Do everything we ask and everything will be okay. Transition to Edgewater. So far, loading screens are a bit long.
They start asking you for some medicine. Come tell me. Keep your distance, friend. Sick house is no place for a traveler.
Had your rations yet?
Yep. Two whole cans of salt tuna.
We don't get a lot of visitors.
Hmm?
Obviously not. Cantina.
Almost lost a finger in the can.
Maintenance, what's this? Use workbench. Workbench allows you to repair, upgrade, and modify your weapons and armor on each screen. Okay. Right, so I've got. I want to sell that. Sell that. What's that? Sell value. Oh, I've got a sword off shotgun. 99. Alright, hang on, I need to. I don't have enough. Don't have enough, damn it. Okay, so. Let's break down. And what's the. Alright, let's modify. Alright, tinker, let's cost 50 bits. No, I wanted to repair down. That's the 6, that's the 6. Where's the 13? There's the 13, so let's break that down, break that down, break that down. Break that down. And keep that. Okay, so we've done some weapon modifying, and we've now got a shotgun. Okay, so everything in here is free game. I don't need to worry about stealing it. Use terminal. Alright, so let's try it again. It makes a right noise. Sounds like someone's got some issues with mechanical people. Am I stealing if I'm in here? Alright, okay, let's get back in there.
Hey, you hear about Wilson?
Heard Marauder's got him.
Just between us, Wilson deserted. Lost his nerve. Ran off in a thick of night.
Shameful state of affairs. Right. I think... yeah. What do we have here? Vendors! Vending machines offer a variety of items, hack skill. Restricted items with a level 40 or higher. Level.
You're safer inside the walls.
You the new worker? Whatever. Make it quick, tenderfoot. I'm busy.
Gravesite fees. I'm here to collect.
Shit. Silas still on about that? Here, take the fees. I'd appreciate it if you didn't tell Reed I was late on my payment. Because they're not my fees and not my gravesite. Guy I worked with shot himself. I paid the bill. If you're not familiar with board law, you ought to be. Law requires delinquent gravesite fees to be paid by the deceased party's closest living relative, which meant me. Shame, though. Eugene was a good worker. Woke up one morning and put a round through his upper story. Can't imagine why. The kid was doing all right at his desk. We all thought he was an upstanding receptionist. Just between the two of us, I'm pretty shocked his weapon didn't misfire. Spacer's choice handguns aren't the most reliable.
Yeah, we've had some experience of that.
Eugene wasn't family. Yeah, I was the closest living person relative to his body at time of death. I'm the one who found him, you see, so I pay the fines.
What?
Suicide's a crime. The legal term is irreparable damage to company property. What Eugene did to himself was vandalism. When one of your workers commits a crime, the entire town pays for it. In other words, Edgewater would have been penalized pretty hard. Whatever Eugene was worth as an asset, we would have had to pay out of pocket to Spacer's Choice. Look around. Edgewater ain't exactly swimming in luxury. We can't afford to pay the body price of a suicide. All I know is Silas asked me for Eugene's gravesite fees, which means he was approved for burial, which means his papers went through, which means the town's in the clear.
Good guy, Silas.
I'm just glad to put this whole ugly affair behind me. Eugene can rest his bones in peace, and the rest of us can get on with our own lives.
Mate, that's a bit fucked up. That is genuinely a little bit fucked up. Corporations. I mean, it's one way to keep people in poverty and in line. Doesn't make it right. I don't think I got seen. Oh, I forgot there was a guard running around. I'm just wondering now if they're gonna make thefts. So, like, if you steal a lot from company property in a certain town, will it negatively impact the town's standing? Right, that's enough looting. Oh, I'm lying, it's never enough. Nothing on them poor mites. Oh, I can go down? Oh god. I'm about 90% certain I'm supposed to come down here later on. Right, let's go. Main quest. Found a bathroom.
Monkey Argo?
I'm sorry, Mr. Thompson, sir. You asked why it's taking so long to fix. The answer's technical.
Don't apologize. Just try using small words for me.
The cans bust open in the oven because she's set to cook Saltuna, which isn't what we've got. Mr. Thompson, I think there's someone here to see you.
Focus, Miss Holcomb. You and I are still talking. Let's start over. Walk me through the process. Show me where it's going awry.
Well, sure. It's mostly on account of what we're feeding into the mechanism.
It puts food in cans. We have food, we have cans. Why won't it work like we need?
She's expecting Saltuna of a certain size. We're filling the cans with, well, not fish.
Interesting. That's a pretty cool space suit. I think we've got enough rotations in now.
Seems we've got a guest. Really now, Parvati, I do wish you'd spoken up. I do apologize. I was given no forewarning of your arrival, or I might have welcomed you at the gates myself. You were saying, Miss Holcomb.
It's just what Bess needs is a proper refurbish. I can bandage her up and what all, but she's just old. Sorry, I'm sorry. I'll do better.
And I do wish you'd stop referring to our cannery as Bess. Personification of company property is strictly contrary to the Spacer's Choice Code of Conduct. My apologies. I am not in the habit of allowing my guests to witness such a row. Now, what can I do for you?
All right. Are you Reed? I was told I should... we can start with introductions. I'm Sleepy.
I'm Reed Thompson, Outpost Administrator. I cannot help but notice you are not in uniform. Yes, so it dawns on me. Seems I allowed my excitement to run away with my wits. Been a few seasons since we've had a visitor pass through.
My ship needs repairs. I'm looking for a power regulator. Yeah.
Only regulator we got is hooked up to the town transformer. Mr. Thompson ain't liable to be keen on dismantling it.
I beg your pardon. I am most emphatically not keen on any such thing. I can't let you have our power regulator. But I happen to know of another one. And I happen to know exactly how you may retrieve it without frying yourself in the process.
Wait, hang on. I think, because I'm a clever lad. Nope. I'm not. Although, sorry guys, I will be right with it.
My proposition benefits the both of us. Please, hear me out. There's a power regulator in the old botanical lab. It's mostly abandoned, so all that power is being squandered. Go down to the geothermal plant. Reroute power from the botanical district over to us. Once their power is shut down, you can have their regulator and be along on your way.
Cool. Right, so... and then we do this, we do this, paste, When you say mostly abandoned.
I was not entirely sure how to tell you this. The botanical labs are not legally inhabited, but there are people who live there. No, I do not imagine they will be pleased. But like a parent disciplining an unruly child, you will be doing them a kindness. The people living in the botanical labs, they're deserters. Former workers. I need them back at their posts. I need them to come home.
Why?
Edgewater is struggling. We haven't hit our production quota in years. If we don't meet our quotas this year, the company might shut us down for good. I need those workers back at their stations. Neither do I. The fault was entirely mine. I pushed them too hard. My hope is that by cutting off their power, you will convince those deserters to come back to town. Before you go to the plant, I want you to stop by the botanical lab. Speak to their leader, Adelaide. Tell her the power's about to go, and that it's time her band of deserters came back to town.
Okay, so at least he's offering them fair warning.
Adelaide's older than the other deserters. She's dignified, kindly. From what I understand, her camp looks to her for leadership. That is not a hypothetical I enjoy entertaining. We need Adelaide back. Nonetheless, I will settle for the return of her followers. We belong to one community, the Spacer's Choice family. If we dissolve into factions, then we will all perish separately. Adelaide will understand that.
I somehow don't think...
Of course, I understand completely. Here, let me give you the passcode to the geothermal plant. A sign of good faith for so politely listening to me as I ramble on.
Are you setting off for the Vale? Because I know my way around. I mean, in case you want a guide. I mean, if that's all right with you, Mr. Thompson. Sir.
I hesitate to part ways with Miss Holcomb, but I cannot deny that she is talented and may prove useful to you.
Great! I got my wrenches and diagnosticators and hairpins and engine tape, so I'm all set.
Well, I am glad to hear that. Best of luck to you, and thank you again for your help. It is a lot to ask of a stranger, I know.
Right. So I am taking a companion, even though I know I said I wasn't going to, mainly because achievements, like right there. Also, I want to see if I can get some information out of her about what's actually going on in Edgewater, because that guy seems too slick to be truly good. So let's have a look at companions and what they do.